Jenkins. I never did have much time for Red Indians myself.
How much further out, sir?
Well, not many more miles now. And look, Jenkins, the sun's coming out.
Oh, goody, sir.
Look! Great Scott!
I can't go on, Jenkins.
I can't go on.
Oh, can't, so we'll sing.
No, Jenkins. Leave me here. I'll be all right. I've got some work I can be getting on with.
We've made it, sir! There it is!
Morning, Mr. Fraser, Mr. Jenkins. Late for work again, I see.
Tonight, we look at Chertenwillow, where we're waiting for the start of what could be, and indeed promises to be, one of the most exciting, and indeed exciting, butler trials of recent years. Lord Bracken, a retired Morris dancer, is to judge between the two butlers, Horrocks and Andre Braithwaite, who will demonstrate their respective powers of loyalty and, indeed, service. And there's her ladyship, who indeed owns one of the butlers we shall be seeing. Lord Churton, another, in fact, owner. Good heavens, who's that? Lord Churton's retainer is the faithful Horrocks, an old favourite of his, this one, who has been with him on countless trials. Horrocks is, of course, well loved for his glass-throwing technique. A really loyal retainer of the old school. Andre Braithwaite, Lady Tweedsmoat's butler, without a lot of experience of trials, but in the pink of condition. Just look at those teeth and indeed the gleam in his eyes. And look at that leg. No, that leg. He's got a beautiful coat on him, and I shouldn't be surprised if we don't, in fact, see a lot more of him. And now for the dinner is served, delivery and obedience test. Both butlers are required to interpret the command, negotiate the obstacles, and in fact, give the dinner is served signal.
I am the little red rooster.
Very quick reaction. Here he comes, good balance. Great control there.
Braithwaite.
Oh dear, slow reaction. You'll have lost points there, but look at that turn. Oh, there's Lady Tweedsmoat. Oh, the bunny dip. Fantastic. What a large crowd here today. Indeed, almost half the village. The next event is indeed the tray catching. Contestants are required to hold a falling tray with two dry sherries and indeed a pink gin thereupon. Oh dear, Horrocks can't quite manage it. What a tragic thing it is to see this faithful old butler no longer able to... Ah, and indeed here is the livestock arriving. Lively and spirited herd of guests there. I can see the butlers are going to have a lot of trouble. And now indeed comes the herding of the guests. A very difficult operation. Horrocks is going well. Braithwaite looks a little flustered. And here comes Horrocks. A firm hand is, in fact, all that's needed. That druid again. Well done, the butlers. They've got the guests sitting down and even removed the druid.
Attention, please!
Oh, what's this? A surprise announcement.
Hay and buns are now being served in the refreshment enclosure.
Curtain to Willow in a state of total confusion. And indeed, in all my years of reporting from the butler trial, I've never seen such a sight. I believe I do recognize the music, Lieutenant Cliche by Prokofiev, the well-known druid. It's, the scene here is quite unbelievable, and in fact, unbelievable. I'm at a loss for words.
Everyone delights to spend their summer's holiday down beside the side of the silvery sea. By the way, I desire for the side of the silvery sea.
Thank you. gained by proof maintained. Our empire shall be strong. Land of hope and glory, mother of the free.